Thank you. Thank you. My friend, after the disappointment of not seeing you in Alamigo, what good fortune to chance upon you here of all places. As you may have heard, the Allied Nations are making a renewed effort to address the primal problem. To that end, have I invited the chieftain of the Vanu to Ishgard, that we might together plot a course. Since the war with the Empire appears to be nearing its conclusion, I would also like to call upon Estinian's Lance. Alas, he is, as ever, a difficult man to find. I am informed he recently paid a visit to the Rising Stones. Should he happen to do so again, be sure to pass on my regards, won't you? But tell me, what business brings you to our fair city this day? A cure for tempering. You never cease to amaze me. Until now, our only hope has been prevention, our every failure irrevocable. But this would rewrite the rules of engagement. It could end the cycle of bloodshed. Very well. You shall have all the ceruleum we can provide, and an airship with which to transport it. In this matter, you may count on Ishgard's full support.
Who would have thought ceruleum weighed so much? Serves me right for being stubborn, I suppose. I should have just done what you did and accepted help.
Good work, you two. This is all we asked for and more. Quite a lot more now that I look at it. Lord Emmerich, eh? And entirely by chance. Ha! Some people have all the luck.
We have also succeeded in configuring the terminals, thanks in no small part to our able assistant.
It's been a while, hero. You seem surprised to see me. Lest you misunderstand, I've no interest in such things as cures for tempering. But if you mean to achieve that which eluded even the storied Allegans, it seemed plain that you would require my expertise. And so it proved. Is that not right, Garland?
Ask Jessie. She was the one who hired you. All I know is you're an employee of the Ironworks now, so you'll bloody well earn your keep.
That wasn't the only reason I agreed to cooperate. I'm reliably informed that Garland and I are destined to unravel the secrets of travel, not only across dimensions, but through time. Doubtless the lion's share of the credit lies with me, 9 parts to Garland's 1. And this research will be a stepping stone to that illustrious achievement.
Very well then. I'll do 1/10 of the work. Just the part that's beyond you.
Whatever you say, Garland.
Right. If everyone's ready, let's begin. All appears to be in order. Now, we just have to wait for it to find us our magic. Why not take this opportunity to put your feet up? This may take a while. It's overloading.
Chief! She won't last much longer!
We'll have to shut it down.
Wait! We're close. So very close.
Oh!
Well, this is going swimmingly.
Please, a moment longer. I beg you. There. No.
I was able to memorize the magic before it faded. It still needs to be put to the proof, but I believe we have our cure.
It's just as well. She'll never run again.
The fault is mine. I'm sorry.
Don't be. It may fall short of dimension hopping, but a cure for tempering is not to be sniffed at. This, my friend, is a world-changing discovery. One we're proud to have had a hand in. A few Magitek terminals are a pittance to pay.
Thank you.
Well, we've done what we can. The rest is up to you.